My name is Melissa Joyeux, and I have been doing Spartan racing since 2017. I started OCR just a little bit before. I am currently a Spartan Canada ambassador. Last year, I completed 6 trifectas. The year before, I did 3. Before that, I had not even considered doing a Spartan Beast. I am not a long-distance runner or an endurance person, but now I have done a 12-hour hurricane heat. I successfully finished that, and a 4-hour hurricane heat, and I was planning to do an ultra this year, but we'll see how that goes. I am also currently a member of the Beast OCR Pro Team, so I compete in age group or elite, depending on the situation and the race. I've been on the podium a little bit, and yeah, so that's where I am. I want to tell you, though, about why I am part of Spartan Racing, and OCR in general. I'm here for the community, and that's the part that I want to talk about, is that some people, including myself, were afraid to do a Spartan race. People think it'll be too hard, they don't think they can finish, they don't know if they can do the obstacles, but what I've learned is that's all okay. Even if you can't do it, there's going to be somebody there. And my most memorable moment in Spartan, in any race I've done, there's been many, many interesting and memorable moments, but one that has stood out and sort of become a key thing to me was last year. It was Canada Day long weekend at Owl's Head. It was a trifecta weekend. I did the sprint on Friday, did well in that, but the heat got to me a lot more than I thought it would. And the next day for the Beast, the heat was still there, and so was the elevation. I was also coming off of an ankle injury. I was just finally starting to feel better and able to do things. And I came down the hill, and we had the Atlas carry, and I tripped over a rock and rolled my good ankle. So my bad ankle was feeling a bit better, but when I rolled my one that had been good, I became quite upset. And then, of course, we had yet another hill to climb up. So I course carried on, and I'm walking up the hill, though I am crying loudly. I couldn't really keep myself together at all, but I knew I just had to keep moving. And another racer saw me and saw what happened. I don't know if she saw that I'd fallen, but she came up to me and she asked if I was okay. And you know, I could barely speak. I mean, climbing the hill and sobbing. She stayed with me. And then I will point out, we were both competing in age group. We were both doing fairly well at that point. It was her stopping to talk to me, or even slowing down to talk to me, was just very nice. So we started talking. We realized we had seen each other off and on through the race. We were running at a similar pace. And despite her English being not her first language, she stuck with me through that hill. We just ended up chatting off and on through the race. I felt that we were both just, even though we sort of go off on our own at times, you know, one of us felt a little stronger and could move a little faster. Our average pace tended to be quite similar. And basically through the race, we were there as supports for each other. I know she's told me later. So in this, I will tell you, she's another ambassador. So Carol is how she introduced herself. So Carolyn. And she had moments as well. She told me after, and I noticed some during the race, but you know, we'd have our good moments and we'd have our bad moments, and we kind of helped each other through. I will say at one point I had an incredibly bad moment. It was it was after the monkey bars, and I saw it, we were near the end, but then we had the sandbag carry, and after climbing to the peak at Owl's Head 6 times, we all had to go back up one more time with the sandbag. I sat down, I picked up the sandbag, threw it on the ground, sat on it, and just started crying again. I am a tearful person, but normally I don't cry that much during a race, but this is one of the races that the whole race itself just got to me. It ended up being one of the races with the most elevation gain in North America. I did Tahoe World Championships at the end of September, and I still, to me, say, for me, the Owl's Head Beast was the hardest race ever done. So with that sandbag, I sat down and started crying. I said, I don't know how I can do this. And an acquaintance of mine that we had been through another race, we had been pit crew on another race together, spent quite a long time getting to know each other. He was helping, Chris was helping at the at the sandbag carrier monkey bars. He was in the same area. He saw me sitting down crying. He walked up to me and said, well, what's going on, Melissa? Get up. Why? You're almost at the end. What's going on here? And I told him, I was like, I just can't handle another hill. He said, well, think of it this way. This is the last hill. That your time is fairly good. So even if it takes you 8 hours still, or 6 hours to finish this one hill, you'll still complete the beast. You may be last, but you'll still be able to finish. So if you take one step every 20 minutes, you'll still be able to finish this thing. And I didn't even notice that I had picked up my sandbag, and as he was talking to me, I'd started walking forward again. And so that was also a huge thing for me. I was able to get going and finish, and as I go up, I get to the top of the sandbag carry area, and there's Kara out there, and we then continue on together and get each other to the finish, realizing, you know, we're almost done. And we crossed the finish line. I made a silly mistake and ended up having to do some burpees near the end, which wasn't great, but we finished around the same time and got to actually, you know, say hello, and I got to thank the person who had helped me through it. I without those two people, I really don't think I would have finished the race. The other positive was, this was a race my mom was there. She hasn't been able to be at many races because I'm in the West, she's in the East. And she had set up at the monkey bars. There was a cheering team for me. As I completed them, I had a whole crowd of people applauding. So really, it was all of those little bits of motivation and the camaraderie, the support that I received through that got me through. And that's what Spartan's about. Is it doesn't matter if you're good or if you're having a really, really bad race, like I was there. You know, sitting on the ground crying on multiple occasions, when I can normally just, you know, run through a race. If I have to do burpees, I have to do burpees, you know, things happen. But when you're having that really rough time, there usually will be somebody there that in a Spartan race, even though you're a competitor, you're trying to win. You know, we were competing for the top 10 there. This was a Canadian national championship, and people stopped to care. And that's what I love about Spartan. That is why I'm still in it. That, and I'm really competitive. I still want to get more podiums and, you know, get up there. But it's the community more than anything else that has me in that particular race, in Spartan, and in the whole community as a whole. So I'd encourage anybody that wants to do a race to try, because it doesn't, even if you're, you know, you've done a sprint, you're not sure if you can do a beast, try it. Even if it takes you 8-10 hours, depending on the course and the time frame you're allowed. But, you know, it takes me less to do some races and longer to do others, depending on how it is, and that's okay. People are there to support you and help you get through. If it's your first time, run it open, and there will always be people who will help boost you up, help pull you up, help push you over, not necessarily carry you, but even then, sometimes, you know, you hurt yourself. I've seen people carry people out over the way. So that's the Spartan community, and that's why I'm a Spartan ambassador, and why I think everybody should try at least once. I hope you get to do some more races.